Absolutely. Yeah, I mean, I think that there's sort of the confines of the anthropological viewpoint, which wants to sort of corral native people and saying, well, this is traditional and this is not traditional, and which sort of begs the question, are native people allowed to change? But historically, they've always adapted new materials and new mediums and ways of working, using tools and so forth. And it really helped the culture develop and grow. And just as any culture would utilize any contemporary tools at their disposal, totem poles were flourished in the turn of the century with the introduction of steel tools. So I mean, it just caused the artwork and the culture to flourish. The Tlingit community or the tribe is split into two halves, and there's either it's a matrilineal society, and you're either born into the eagle or the raven, you follow your mother's side, and then each side or each moiety has different house groups, and within those house groups are different symbols that like either like a bear or the bear, the killer whale, frog, shark, all kinds of things, and then or a box, the box house. And my family comes from the Kagwantan, which is that was our that's our house group. And so in our family symbol is the killer whale. We also own the brown bear and the eagle and wolf. And so those are the symbols that sort of explain about my family and where we come from, and which, because it's an oral tradition, and a lot of those symbols are family properties. They're only owned by those particular families, and those are the ones that display those symbols to illustrate where they come from.